Hey everyone, it's Mike at 7D, therideshare.com. Welcome. It's 5 in the morning and we're catching a couple rides down to Miami before we see one of the big characters in my book, Ricky Smalls. His lab needs a floor put in, something I'm really good at but I hate doing. But come on, I'm going to show you something new today. Enjoy the ride. Picking up for Gigi?
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome. How are you doing today?
Good, and you?
All right. We're in the 1420 doorway. If it's hot, cold, and windy, and you want the windows up, just let me know, okay?
All right,
thank you. Cool. We're here at Ricky Smalls' lab. I went ahead and ripped up the carpet, and I did a little sweep to get the floor ready, get it prepped. You see there are my little tools, my saws, and everything ready to go. Now we're going to scrape the floor and make sure it's smooth so we can put the underlayment on. After scraping the floor, make sure you get all the bumps from the extra glue or extra concrete out. You sweep it one more time, real nice, get it real nice and smooth. Once your floor is prepped and ready to go, now the fun begins. This is your underlayment, a moisture barrier. This will keep your laminate from rotting out. Your laminate's a floating floor, it's gonna float right on top of it. Okay, everyone, so once you have your underlayment slash moisture barrier down, now you're ready to install some laminate. Make sure you have the correct tool. You can get a little kit right at Home Depot. You got your mallet. You got the block that you're gonna need. Comes a little kit for the hard edges to get it together. And then you need spacers. You need to leave a quarter inch between your walls and your laminate. A quarter inch for expansion. When wood heats up, it expands. So you need to leave a quarter inch so it doesn't expand and buckle up on you. Before you install that plank, check all the corners. You don't wanna put down a plank with chipped corners. Now the next row needs to be a little shorter, not the same as the one you began with, or else everything will be even and buckle up also. This corner will cut together. You need a table saw, you can't just use the regular hand saw. Alright guys, 300 square feet down in one day. Let's come back tomorrow and shoot the quarter rounds. Day two, let's shoot the quarter rounds and the moldings to this bad boy. You gotta cut your angles at 45 degrees and then check them out before you put it in. That's how it'll look when you cut your angle at 45 degrees. This piece, you gotta glue down, because there's concrete and no way for the nail to go. Guys, once you're done with the floor in the quarter round, you put your T-molding, you get glued down, do your transitions, and then cock, it is time to go home. Hey guys, Maya 70 therideshare.com. I hope you enjoyed the video and making the little floor. I hope you learned something. This content you're only going to find at www.70theridesshare.com, 70 the rideshare Insta, and 70 the rideshare Facebook. It is now 7 o'clock, day 2, Tuesday. Time to go home and call it. Drive safe and God bless. Gigi, check it out. I don't know if you like to read, but I published my book not too long ago. 7 Days of Rideshare, Driving Through COVID-19, Divorce, and Christianity. If you go to the webpage, you can get the first chapter and see some short videos. Cool, thank you. If you give me a moment, sweetie, I'll go ahead and get that door for you.